Why is it that when a white a man criticizing Islam, when it goes to LGBT, it becomes more complicated than other criticism of Islam?
Yeah, so why is it more complex? So, because I think if you think about the whole ethos of identity politics is actually that gay people would be seen as an oppressed minority against the heterosexual minority, right? A heterosexual majority. But something has happened where with white gays, particularly white gay males, they're now seen as privileged because actually they don't have the level of homophobia in their community that actually Islamic gays do, or people of Islamic heritage who are gay. So now, when you're criticizing as a white gay man, and also I think as a white gay woman, but less so, but as a white gay man, when you're criticizing Islamic homophobia, well, actually, you're just speaking from this place of privilege and you're being racist. But the truth for white gays is not a story of privilege. It's a story of having to go to war to fight for their human rights in a country like the UK, all across the West, to win equality and civil liberties around gay rights.
I wanted to say one thing about the white privilege thing. Is this that the most powerful privilege in the 21st century is a sense of perpetual victimhood.
Yes!
That's it. If you have this perpetual sense that I'm being victimized, you are more privileged in this day and age than any group whatsoever.
Secular Jihadists is an increasingly influential podcast with much of its growing audience in Muslim-majority countries, advocating for atheists, secularists, and Enlightenment thinkers. We want to reach out to more people. If we reach 500 patrons, we will be able to translate our shows into Arabic, Urdu, Persian, Bengali, Malay, Turkish, and other languages in these countries. Help us get there at patreon.com/SJME.